This is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time I will be playing the War of the Outer Gods scenario, and as it's coming out on Christmas Day, happy holidays to everybody. Let's see how we can manage this scenario. So I will be playing Joe Diamond for this true solo playthrough of this scenario, and this is the regular version. There is a mass multiplayer version that is in the rule booklet. Let's look at Joe's deck first. I built Joe's deck with 39 experience, so there are 4 weaknesses in the deck. I drew Dread Curse, Obsessive Paranoia, and Accursed Follower as the basic weaknesses. I built the deck to have good mobility, fighting skill, and good ways to get clues. Joe is a real good true solo investigator, as he has 4 in intellect and 4 in combat, so usually you can easily fight and investigate with him. He also has access to the mobility cards from the Seeker aspect, and because I'm using the latest taboo list, I'm using the Pathfinders that cost now 3 experience. Also, I'm using the Machete that only costs 1 experience anymore in the taboo version. Then there are a lot of staple cards like the new cryptographic cipher that helps you investigate better or do it as a free action. Also, I added some extra fighting capability with 1 level 2 dynamite blast. This scenario can be quite enemy intensive, so you might need to clear out the location with multiple enemies in it. And of course, there is a lot to go through on the decklist, so I won't go through that intensely. So I will post the link to the decklist into the video description, of course, so you can check it out with better time. But let's get into the scenario. We are playing the War of the Outer Gods on standard difficulty. The biggest thing to note is that we have 3 different agenda decks. These are the 3 factions that are fighting amongst themselves to get their Elder God awoken, and we are trying to prevent that from happening. We are basically trying to prevent these cults from turning Earth into a battle zone. So the 3 factions are green, red, and blue. Two main rule additions in this scenario are that we haven't seen before are warring. Warring is a keyword like hunter, so a warring enemy moves in the enemy phase towards other warring enemies. So these factions are fighting each other, and we are caught in the middle. And when they fight each other, they deal their damage and or horror as damage to each other, and they are activated in a specific order, and the order is green, blue, red. Then the other keyword is wards. We can place wards on these agendas, and basically we put an clue token there, and when a doom would be placed on the agenda, we remove the clue token so the doom doesn't get placed. And we try to slow down these warring factions and get our act advanced like normal. And there's basically fluff text here, and which tells you how to resolve this. All of these have a doom threshold of 6. Then we have a clue threshold of 3, but we can only spend clues when there are no cultist enemies in play. So we need to get rid of these cultists before we can advance this and start advancing the act into our favor. But I think that is enough of the scenario and the deck. I think the best thing to show this scenario is to just start playing. So let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hands. So we draw 5 cards, let's see. Okay, so we hit weakness, let's redraw. Now we get forewarned, beat cop, vicious blow, burning the midnight oil, and take the initiative. I think we really don't like any of this. I would like to get a weapon and maybe something to boost our mobility, so let's redraw everything. Okay, we got detective's codes. Then we get the cryptographic cipher, Dr. William T. Melson, Pathfinder, and Dynamite Blast. So pretty decent mulligan. So let's shuffle these back into our deck. We are starting to play in Arkham, and we have connecting locations, which are the streets of Montreal, streets of New York City, and streets of Providence. This map is basically divided in 3. Each of these has one ritual site where the cultists start. And these are our aloof and warring, and they start in play. So they start moving towards each other right away. And we are smack in the middle of it all. So I think we need to... We could let them all pile up in Arkham and throw a dynamite blast in there to get rid of them. That might be a good plan. Let's see how the game develops. So I think first action, I think we'll actually play down Pathfinder. Second action, we'll actually, let's keep the Pathfinder in hand still and put the cryptographic cipher in play. And there are 3 secrets on this. So I think I'm using an action, using one secret from here, and I'll drop the shroud to down by 2, so it's a shroud of 3. So I'm investigating, and I'm investigating 4 versus 3. So let's see if we can. We can investigate this location, and it's a minus 1, so we grab this clue. And last action, I think we could actually get our resource. That is that. So that is the. This gets exhausted. So that is the investigation phase, enemy phase. So we start moving these guys, and they move in this order: red, blue. I mean green, blue, red. So green moves first, then blue, and then red. And that is the enemy phase. They are not the same location, so they don't fight yet. We go to upkeep. Now we draw a card. We get the Eureka, and we gain 1 resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. And as I predicted, I forgot my Hunt's deck for the first turn, so we would have had Emergency 8, but we shuffled that. Yeah. Well, I try to remember the Hunt's deck from now on. Okay, so we add a Doom to the agenda. Actually, we add Doom to each of these agendas. And they are added in order. So if one pops, it pops first, then we add the Doom on the others. But the counter card for this turn is Death and Decay. So it's a revelation. You must decide, choose one, place one Doom on the blue agenda. You and each asset you control take one direct damage. Choose an item asset you control and remove it from the game. So I think I'm taking one direct damage. Because we don't want to add any Doom anywhere. We'll go to the investigation phase. I think... first action, let's go to the streets of Montreal. So it's a 4-shot location with one clue. Second action, I think I'll use this and drop the shroud to 2, and I'll commit Eureka to the test. So I'm testing 5 versus 2. It's a skull, and skull is minus 1 for each clue you have. I have 1 clue, so it's a minus 1. So we succeed, we get this clue, and oh yeah, and we have this. Okay, it's the emergency aid again. I actually could play it and heal 1 damage. So we get 3 cards and pick 1. I think I'm needing more resources later, so I'll take the bird night oil. And last action, I'll just play this emergency aid to do 1 damage. And that is our turn. So, enemy phase. The green moves here first, then the blue, and then the red. Then this activates, so the green hits something. I'll just hit the blue with the green. The blue hits red, and the red hits green. So we don't want to let these guys kill each other, because every time these guys kill each other, they get doom on their agenda, and we don't want to let that happen. So instead, I think I'm dynamite blasting next turn here to kill off everybody. And that way we don't add any doom anywhere. Okay, so that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep. This should be ready. Exhausted, so we read it and we draw a card. We get another Eureka and we gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agendas. Counter card is Bringer of Paradise. So it spawns in the Shrine of Makhan Arkat, so here. And it's Aloof, Retaliate, Warring. Spawn Shrine of Makhan Arkat. Forced at the end of the round, place one resource on Bringer of Paradise as a mutation. Then, if there are 3 or more mutations on it, remove 2 of them and place 2 Doom on the green agenda. So, we need to kill off that guy sometime in the future, but he's not a big threat right at the moment. Instead, these guys, we need to deal with them right away, because they are all cultists. So while they are on play, I can't advance the act which we need to do. So first action, let's turn. Okay, so we get our weakness. So I'm just letting this go because it's a standalone game. So dynamite blast, we'll throw a dynamite here. It costs 4. And we deal 3 damage to each enemy and its investigator at the chosen location. This action doesn't provoke attacks of opportunity, so these guys are all defeated. And second action, let's move to Chateau Ramsey. It's a 2-shroud location. Action test, willpower 4. If you succeed, gain 1 clue from the token pool. Well, I think we are just investigating here. We could actually do it as a fast action using the cipher. So we'll use the last cipher. And it gets plus 1 shroud. It's a fast action, so actually let's actually save this for later. Forgot I have the Burning the Midnight Oil in hand, so I'll play that. I'll commit Eureka, so we gain 2 resources from playing Burning the Midnight Oil. We are investigating 5 versus 2. It's a 0, so we grab this clue. And then I will spend these clues right away. So we have no cultist enemies in play because this guy is not a cultist, it's humanoid mutated. So we get a portal opens. There's a lot of fluff text, but basically put the set aside dimension location into play, unsealed side face up. And I'll just place it over. I'll just place it over here. It's not connected to anything. And let's see the next act. So, close the portal. Seal off the hub dimension before it is too late. Action, if you are at a ritual site, you try to seal off the portal, place one of your clues around hub dimension. Then you may test. Willpower or intellect 2. If you succeed, place one of your clues around hub dimension. Then forced, when any amount of doom is placed on a player card, place that amount of doom on any agenda as well. Objective, if your group has sealed off the hub dimension, advance. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Before that, we resolve the Eureka. And I'll grab the Vicious Blow, because next turn we are playing the guns and I want to one-shot that Bringer of Paradise. Please get shuffled back into our deck. This comes into play, it really doesn't matter. At the end of the round, we ready up our assets and stuff and we draw a card, we get Hallowed Mirror and gain one resource. So, that is that turn. At the end of the round, this guy gets one resource placed on him. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agendas. Encounter card is. We get the Disciple of the Spawn. Aloof Warring Spawn the Burning Pit. Forced at the end of the round, if no blue or green enemies are in play, place one dune on the red agenda. So now these are opposite factions and both are warring, so they start to move towards each other. But I think we have to kill off this so it doesn't add a bunch of doom that may cause the red faction to gain advantage, but it is what it is. We'll see how it goes. We get the seeking answers, which would be really good if we had multiple locations connected with clues. So I think we are just not caring about that right at the moment. First action, I'll play the detective's cults, and this is a tool, so we can have this and this in play at the same time. It costs 4, and it has 4 ammo. Second action, we'll move here. Actually, this guy gets to run away from us. We can't stop that. Oh well. So, the Shrine of Makan Arkat is a 3-shroud location with 1-2 ritual site, Montreal. Pre-triggered ability. Draw the top card of the encounter deck. Place one ward on the green agenda. Group limit once per round. So let's think about this for a moment. I think the last action will be to investigate here. But this guy doesn't... Yeah, it needs to have three. Yeah, then if there are 3 or more mutations on it, remove 2 of them and place. So it doesn't trigger yet, so we're fine. Let's just investigate here. And I think I'm investigating. I'll use the cryptographic cipher. So we drop the shroud to 1. I won't commit anything to the test. And it's an elder sign. We can add 1 insight. I'll just put the emergency aid underneath here. Then we succeed. We grab this clue. And next turn we can... on a later turn we can try to add clues onto the hub dimension. But right now it's not big of a use because we only have 1 clue and we want to action compress and get 2 clues at a time over there. Enemy phase. Green moves first. Red moves second. Because there are no clues. We add 1 resource as a mutation here. There are other enemies, so we don't add any doom anywhere. We go to upkeep, we ready up, we draw a card, we get forewarned. We shuffle, actually this got shuffled into the deck already. We gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add dooms to the agendas. And as a reminder, we have now 4 doom and the threshold is 6. So once this gets advancing, we add a lot of cards into the encounter deck. And the scenario gets more difficult. Let's see, we get while they sleep. Revelation, for each faction that has the most enemies in play, place 1 doom on that faction's agenda. If no enemies are in play, place no doom. And while they sleep, gain search. So I actually have to check because we have equal amount of enemies in play if they are tied. So I couldn't find an answer quickly. So for each faction that has the most enemies, so yeah, it's right on the card. So there are most enemies on the green and red faction, so both get one doom added. And that is a real bummer, because now they will be advancing next turn. Well, that is the mythos phase. We'll head on to the investigation phase. We reveal shortcut, which is really nice. We are definitely playing that. So first action, we'll move here. Let's drop the shortcut here. And I was thinking when I built the deck that I will definitely add the shortcut to Arkham, but Arkham reads Arkham cannot have attachments, so a shortcut can't be attached to Arkham. It would be too powerful if you could just keep on moving through the Arkham hub to the different parts, but still placing it here will save me one move when I start running around. So I'll just drop it there as a fast action. I'll engage this guy as second action, and third action I'll shoot with my detective's Colt. We are fighting 5 versus 3, and I'll commit the vicious blow to the test. So it's a -1. So we deal 3 damage to this enemy, so it gets defeated just in the nick of time, so we don't add any extra doom there. But now the red faction will go into the lead, and that will complicate things. So that was my whole turn. We'll actually use, before our investigating turn ends, I'll use the shortcut to move to Arkham. Yeah, this remains in play. And enemy phase. No warring enemies, so this guy doesn't move. He just stays there. Upkeep. We draw a card. We get a machete. Gain one resource. And this guy adds one doom to the red agenda. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so one thing I noticed while I was having a small break between rounds. The attacks the cultist made at the start of the scenario are not allocated like I choose. They are in fact allocated in faction order, so that each attack goes to the enemy with the least health. So just to fix the situation, we had green, blue and red enemies here. So the green hit the red, then the red enemy had least health remaining, so the blue enemy hit the red and killed it. So we add one doom onto the blue agenda. This will make the next round a bit difficult, but this is the easiest way to correct that error. So we go to the mythos phase, we add doom. So we are actually advancing each of these, but they are advanced in order. So we start from the green one. So we remove all doom. Then we flip this. So if you are playing in standalone mode, add one cultist token to the chaos bag. I'll do that actually in a moment. I'll just put it here for now. Then shuffle two set aside bringers of paradise enemies, the three hunt down treacheries, and the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. So we get two Bringer of Paradises. I'll just place them here. And three of these. And then the encounter discard pile. But wait, there's more. If this is the first agenda to advance to 1B, spawn the set-aside horrific Shoggoth enemy at the Shrine of Makarv Arkat. And this is, so we spawn the horrific Shoggoth over here. And these two are removed. And this, let's look at the horrific Shoggoth for a moment. So it's a 4 fight, 4 health and 2 evade monster Shoggoth mutated. Retaliate warring, horrific Shoggoth gets plus 1 damage for each mutating mutation on it. Forced, when horrific Shoggoth attacks, place 1 resource on it as a mutation. And it starts from here. So these are, again, running towards each other, but then we'll okay, let's look at the agenda 2A first. So a bunch of love text. The main thing is that the next agenda doom threshold is 6 per group, so it's just 6 in a single player game, and that is all important stuff from that. And then we advance the blue agenda, so we add a tablet, we shuffle 2 set aside ethereal entity enemies, and the 3 inevitable end treacheries, and the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. And because this is not the first agenda to advance, we don't do anything else. So we put 3 of these, and 2 of these, and that's it. And then we advance the red one, and now because there is more than 6 doom here, we bleed the one leftover doom onto the next agenda. So the red is actually ahead of the other factions for the next agenda. And we add one Elder Thing token. We shuffle 3 of the 4 set aside True Logog enemies, and the 2 transformified treacheries, and then the counter discard pile into the encounter deck. So we put 1, 2, 3 of the 4, and these 2, and we'll shuffle it. This all, so we basically doubled the encounter deck size. Okay, so now we still need to draw the encounter card, and it is a Zealot of Paradise, so it spawns here. And I think we are just leaving the factions fighting each other and try to advance the act as fast as possible. And we need 6 clues to advance, so let's see how that goes, but yeah. So, let's start the investigation phase. So we have seeking answers. That is actually really good. So I'm actually paying 1 resource to move freely, and because this is quite busy, I'll just let these guys go from here to here and stuff like that. I'll just move here. Then, first real action, I'll move here. Then, I'll investigate, and I'm using the seeking answers. So Investigate if you succeed, discover two total clues from amongst your location and a connecting location. And we are investigating location with two shroud. So 4 versus 2. And it's a -2, so we succeed. We get two clues. Last action, we'll just move here. Okay. And that is our whole turn. Let's see. Enemy phase. These are both warring, so they both move here. This is warring, it moves here. And nothing else happens. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get take the initiative, and we gain one resource. Okay, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agendas. Encounter card for this turn is Hunt Down. Revelation, place one resource on the mutated enemy with the highest fight and application. That enemy readies, moves one location at a time until it reaches your location and engages you. Then it attacks you. If no mutated enemies are in play, hunt down, gain search. I think I really don't want that to happen. I'll play forewarned. I'll drop one of my clues and cancel this revelation effect. Okay, and that is the mythos phase. We get emergency aid, not helpful for this turn. I think first action, I'll just investigate. Let's see, I'll use the take the initiative for this. And it's a -4. So we are 7 versus 3, so -4, we still succeed. If we would have failed, place one card committed to this test face down underneath an insect enemy as a swarm card. We don't have any insects in play yet, but we got that clue. Second action, let's investigate again. Actually, I'll take a risk. I'll actually use this ability. So, well, no, I don't know. I'll just investigate. 4 versus 3. Don't have anything to boost this. Okay. It's a -4, so we fail. Last action, we'll place one clue here. Then we'll test intellect 2, so 4 versus 2. It's a -3, so we don't get to place another clue on the hub dimension. But that is our turn. Enemy phase. So the green faction goes first, so we'll move these guys over here. This guy can't move because they are all in the same location. So green hits first. This guy dies. Green adds one doom to the agenda. And okay, and this gets a mutation because it attacked. That is the villain enemy phase. We draw a card when we gain one resource, and at the end of the round there are no other factions in play, so this Zealot of Paradise will add one to the green agenda. Okay, well, and at the end of our round we'll shuffle this card back into the deck. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agendas. Encounter card is. It's the Bringer of Paradise. It spawns up here. Actually, let's move this around a bit. So I'll keep this here. So these can come here. So I think the green faction is getting ahead of everything else quite fast. First action, I will play down Pathfinder. Second action, I'll investigate. I'm investigating 4 versus 3, and it's a plus 1. We grab this last blue from here, and last action, I will place one of my clues here, then try this action. I have nothing to commit, so I'll just test 4 versus 2. It's a minus 2 because I have 2 clues, so I succeed. I place one of these clues. So I'm halfway there. I need 3 more clues to close this portal. And we'll use Pathfinder to move here so that next round we can try to get to the other side to find more clues. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw a card, we get the steadfast, we gain one resource. Then we place one mutation here, and this adds one doom to the green agenda. So unfortunately that will be advancing next round. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are adding more doom. And the green one goes over the threshold. Okay, so we add one cultist token into the bag. Then, if the horrific shogot enemy is set aside, shuffle into the encounter deck, it is in play. If this is the first agenda to advance to B, spawn the set aside pile broodmaster enemy at the shrine of Arkat. Okay, so we get even more green baddies onto the table. So while Broodmaster, we really need to find a way to end this quick before the green faction rolls into victory. So it has Hunter, Retaliate, while Broodmaster gets plus 1 health for each mutation on it. Forced, when one or more mutations would be placed on an enemy, place one additional mutation on that enemy. Okay, so this actually boosts this and this guy by putting more and more mutations on them. That is not good. So the counter card is Hunt Down. Okay. Well, this is actually. So, place one resource on the mutated enemy with the highest fight. The highest fight is at the moment. These are equal. So this, I'll just give it to this guy. And that actually places one more here. But then it moves here, engages us. So it readies moves until it reaches your location and engages you, then it attacks you if no mutated enemies are in play, hunt down gets yours. So it attacks me, I'll take one horror and yeah, when it attacks me Okay, I'll take 4 damage. Ouch. And this guy has retaliate, so this is actually not that good, because now we could die. But let's see, we get working a hunch. If we can kill this guy, that can be quite helpful. Get one free clue, but let's see first. First action, we'll shoot. So we are shooting 5 versus 4. I'll use steadfast. We still have 5. Let's count. We have 5 plus 4, so we get +2, 5, so 7 versus 4. And it's a cultist, it's a -3, so I hit. I deal 2 damage on this enemy. Then I need to try to kill it. I'll use steadfast again. Same thing. 7 versus 3. And he hit the cultist token, so this is dead. Thank God. Okay. Well, we are hurting, but we're still in the game. I'll use Pathfinder to move here. I'll pay 1 resource per investigator to move to streets of New York City. And last action, I'll play working a hunch to grab the clue from here. And that is my turn. Enemy phase. This has hunter, so it moves here. And at the end of the round, we add the doom here. We add a mutation here and another from this one. And there are 3, so we remove 2 and we add 2 here. So this is really accelerating this, unfortunately. But yeah, that is that turn. Let's go to the next. No, we still need to draw a card. We get Dr. Milan Christopher and we gain 1 resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add Doom to the agendas. The red one is 1 away from popping, and countercard is inevitable end. You must decide, choose 1. Place 1 doom on the blue agenda. Choose 3 cards in your hand and remove them from the game. Remove the top 6 cards of your deck from the game. Shuffle each weakness, remove this way into your deck. Honestly, I think we are nearing the end game, so I'll just remove 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we hit 1 weakness, so these get removed from the game. So we lost 45 automatic. Dr. William T. Mailsem, cryptographic cipher, perception, pathfinder. This gets shuffled into the deck. Okay, then we get shortcut. I'll just put it into play over the streets of New York City. I'll use the shortcut to move over. I only need 1 more. So I'll just shortcut over. Actually, I'll move here, because this is a lower shroud location. We'll investigate here. I'll commit Dr. Milan Christopher to the test. I'm investigating 5 versus 2. So it's a -1. We grab this clue. We'll pathfinder to this burning pit. We'll, as a second action, put 1 clue here. Then we'll try the tests. So 4 versus 2. It's a -1. We place another clue here. And last action, we'll put the 6th clue here. Phew. So, while there are 6 clues per investigator or more around hub dimension, your group has sealed off the hub dimension. If your group has sealed off the hub dimension, advance. If you are playing in single group mode, when your work is done, you and your companions lie in the cold ground, your skin tingling with otherworldly currents. The night sky is filled with stars and no longer blotted out by swirling black entities or alternate dimensions swatted in uncanny mists. The investigators have sealed Earth away from the cataclysmic war of the outer gods. Resolution 1. Resolution 1. The hub's many doorways are now sealed tight under your stern control. With the hub sealed, the cult's fighting over its ownership should hopefully return to operating in secrecy, perhaps waiting for a time when the hub reopens and they can use it to advance their cruel agendas. Until then, the Earth is safe, relatively speaking. And we get to add a bunch of assets into our deck. I won't spoil the assets. Then we get experience. So let's see, we cleared these victory point locations. So 3 plus we get plus, 2 additional experience from as they have prevented all of the other gods from completing their schemes. So 5 experience, and well, we got 2 further experience from the unsolved case. But yeah, that is basically the War of the Outer Gods. As a true solo play or as a single group play in epic multiplayer, we would have had a complete Act 3A still to play, but I won't go into detail that. And that is basically it. I think my deck is way overtuned for this scenario. I think maybe 19 or something like that experience is more suited. So with so much experience and ways to run around the map, so effectively makes this a bit easier than it should maybe be. But still, we weren't that far away from advancing this. I actually don't know what happens when that advances. Maybe we get into some kind of end game or something like that, but who knows. I won't spoil that for myself or anybody else, so you have to play and find out for yourself. But again, thanks for tuning in as this comes out Christmas Day, so happy holidays to everybody. Thanks for watching, and until next time.